Hello there, lovely people. It's Alex from Nintendo Life here, and welcome back to Alex Asks. And last time, I asked you, lovely lot, do you think that the Nintendo Switch really needs a web browser and Netflix and all that gravy stuff? Now, I do want to really quickly apologize for the lateness of this video. Unfortunately, we were too busy doing Switch stuff for me to really be able to take the time out to do this, but no worries, it's happening now. It's not going anywhere, don't you worry. Anyway, let's crack on. Yeah, let's just see what a few of you have to say. Jake.06 says it needs a web browser for one reason, hotel Wi-Fi. I don't know why, but it just tickles me to think of a place called hotel Wi-Fi, and it's just a place where the beds are crap, but the Wi-Fi is great. Hotel Wi-Fi, yes, it is a bit of a bane of everyone. You've got to use some sort of web browser in order to go in and log in and put in all your details so they can send you a million spam messages all about that stuff. Whenever I do it, I just put in a false email address. That's a free tip from me. But are you going to do it when you've not got a web browser on the Switch? Well, worry ye not, there is going to be a web applet in the Switch, so it's designed for that sort of login system. So if you go to any sort of hotspot that requires you to, you know, bring up a web page and log in through that means, that will still work. That, you know, just sort of like a little window, I imagine, will pop up. Something like that. It's coming in the first day one update. So yeah, you got that covered. You don't have to worry about that. That's a really nice and straightforward question. Portal King says, does the Switch need a web browser and Netflix, etc.? No, because those applications don't ship units. Would it be highly convenient if the Switch had a web browser and Netflix, etc.? Of course. Or at least I assume that's what it says. For some reason, it's cut off the end bit. And that seems to happen sometimes. And honestly, I have no idea why. I think it's when I zoom into the page or something. Let's move on. Yeah, I think that's pretty much my feeling about it. You know, sort of, I certainly wouldn't say no to Netflix or a web browser or anything like that. Personally, I don't see myself using it very often, but if it's there, I'll probably use it. So yeah, it would be welcome, but I'm not going to lose any sleep over it. Marcus Kramer says, I tried the browsers from the 3DS and the Wii U, and even Steam Link. They have one thing in common, too slow, too hard to navigate, and many sites don't work properly. Everyone has a smartphone, so really no console needs a web browser at all. Just costs unnecessary development times they should put into the gaming part of these, well, gaming devices. Smiley face. Actually, it was a winky face. I'll try that again. As for streaming services, I like using them on my Wii U, but it really isn't necessary. Most people have a smart TV or some other smart device they use those anyway. I wouldn't say no if the Switch got these though. Yep, again, that's pretty much my opinion. I realized after I asked it that this is quite a closed question. You've managed to give some really good answers though, so we'll move on to those, but there's not really much I can say in rebuttal or support. So I won't be saying much. Himpontainus says, I watch YouTube videos every day on my Wii U, so it'll be a letdown if the Switch doesn't offer that function. YouTube is one of those things where I think it really is sort of a beast of its own. Yes, generally people use it in web browsers, although these days more people are using it on mobile. Believe me, I've got the stats to prove it. But so many people are using it outside of just general web browsing and things like that. So a dedicated app could work as long as it's a good one and not like the Wii U version, because that was rubbish. Jabba the Pug says, the Switch does need things like the web browser and YouTube because that's mainly what I use my Wii U for. Over 1,000 hours of using the web browser on the Wii U and my TV. Wow, I don't think I've ever met anyone who's used a Wii U for 1,000 hours just to browse the web. That's really surprising. But then again, I suppose it is a decent device for that sort of thing. It's a bit slow, to be honest, but apart from that, yeah, no, it's pretty good. And then they go and seal the deal by saying something crazy like, who doesn't want Alex on their TV? Oh, get away with you. John Val Capel says, I think a web browser is coming, just not at launch. That's what happened with the 3DS as well. When it launched, it basically told you the web browser will be made available later via a system update. I mean, it is at least in part a portable unit. That means it's going to have to contend with Wi-Fi networks that have a login web page, like hotels and public transport. At least here in the Netherlands, buses and trains have Wi-Fi like that. Not sure how it is in other countries. We have it over here as well, although generally not on buses, but we have it on a few. It absolutely needs a web browser for those, so hopefully that will be done soon after launch. In the same vein, I think Netflix, etc. are coming in fact to the Switch. They just couldn't get those apps ready for the launch window. They just couldn't get those apps ready for the launch window. Well, as I said earlier in the video, the web applet will allow you to use those sort of public Wi-Fi things, so there's no worries about anything like that. And in regards to what else you said, yeah, I can kind of see where you're coming from. Again, I've sort of already said pretty much everything, you know, in regards to my opinion about it, so I just sort of have to blither on for a bit about Netflix and opinions. I like Netflix. move on. Byron Patterson says the Nintendo Switch does need a web browser and multimedia apps, considering it's a portable console that you can take with you. People would love to have Netflix on a plane or wherever they are where the Switch are. Well, wherever they and the Switch are, that makes far more sense. But at the same time, it is a gaming system, so at launch it should focus on getting the games, and as many people buy the Switch, bring these... I think we've had another cut-off comment, so I'll have to fill in the blanks on my own. The Switch bring these potatoes to market to make sure you get the best price for them. Byron, you make some good points, but by the same token, I don't know why you're talking about potatoes in a video about the Switch. I mean, there's no correlation between potatoes and the Switch. Leonardo Cologne says, why was the PlayStation 2 so extremely popular? Because it streamlined and cheapened having a gaming console and having a media player. Xbox and PS4 are also popular for similar reasons. In short, people want the most bang for their buck and will prefer getting something that plays games and media as opposed to just one. It was a mistake to omit them from the Switch. I really do understand where you're coming from, but I think the thing with the PS2 is it was a totally different time, you know, sort of. Everyone wanted those sort of all-in-one units because they would save money on it. But now, everything, every single device you get has the ability to play Netflix and, you know, web browse and things like that. People's TVs have that functionality as it is out of the box. So these sort of, you know, multimedia things, despite what Microsoft wants to believe, are not that popular as they were. I think people want things that have a little bit more focus on them so that they can get the best quality out of it rather than just something that sort of generally does everything. I think because technology is now so much more affordable, people are able to buy dedicated units. I think that's why, well, I mean, to a degree, because you also still have smartphones and things like that, which really are an all-in-one thing, but that really is, when it comes to all-in-one devices, that's all you need. Smartphones, they've got a camera, they've got a screen, you know, so you can watch Netflix, which is Netflix, Netflix, Netflix is what we're going to talk about today. Earthbound Benji says, I do think at least a web browser is important. I used my Wii U for live streaming Nintendo Directs so that everyone could watch them on the telly screen. You know, the more I think about it, the more I think there's no reason why Netflix and stuff like that can't come later down the line. In fact, they probably will, didn't they? I don't think the Wii U had Netflix to begin with, did it? It didn't have BBC iPlayer. Or maybe it just doesn't now. So really, it's the web browser that's in contention here, because I mean, they could bring it down on later down the line, but you know, would it interfere with other things? Would it really be that useful when everyone's got a smartphone? Probably not. It's just, I had to talk about something. I'm a pug, Sir Donuts. You know, we're getting a lot of pugs today, says it needs Netflix. What am I gonna watch the toaster show on if it doesn't? What am I gonna watch the potato show on? The Switch needs Netflix. You know, when I picked out that comment, I'd forgotten that it had the potato reference. So that's pretty cool, because I've already sort of done that. That's pretty cool. I mean, I didn't do it, Errol did, because he exists, he's a real person. And finally, Marcus Ayrton says, even the Wii U had a web access, even the 3DS had a web browser and YouTube. Why are they removing it? Who knows? Why should they keep it? Well, to keep the sole purpose of the console. Watch Netflix, YouTube, whatever on your telly, and quickly take it wherever you go. Come on, Nintendo. I don't really think that's the sole purpose of the console. No, sorry, I tell a lie, I misread that. Misunderstood what you mean is the sole purpose is picking up and taking it with you. I thought you meant the sole purpose was Netflix and web browser, which just boggled my mind. There is certainly an element to that. There's nothing really out there at the moment that allows you to do that in the same way. I mean, you could argue that you can do it with a laptop. You know, have a laptop plugged in, you got Netflix going, and then you want to take it with you. You can just unplug the HDMI cable and take the laptop with you. But it's not the same sort of seamless, easy experience. And I think just by, you know, sort of sliding on the Joy-Cons, taking it with you, you wouldn't even really need the Joy-Cons on there, although it would be good just because, you know, then you're charging them as well, which is always good. And you just take it with you and you continue watching the same thing uninterrupted. I think that is a strong point. That's something that, madly, I hadn't even considered, which... That's stupid. Bad Alex, bad Alex. Massive thanks to everybody who left a comment. Unfortunately, I can't read all of your comments out because I am only one man with only 8 fingers and 2 thumbs and many toes, but you do have a chance to get one of your comments read out in the next episode. And so my question for you this week is, unfortunately, gonna be a little bit later because there is not gonna be an episode next week again either. I'm so sorry about this, but unfortunately, I'm just not able to do it. Unfortunately, I have to go to a funeral, which is not very good, but I'm not gonna dwell on that for a video. In fact, let's just just, you know, I'm just going to ask the question. Now that you have a Nintendo Switch, indeed, if you do have one, what are the features that you enjoy most about it? And what are the games that you enjoy most about it? And if you don't have one, what are the features that you're most looking forward to playing? Or indeed having? You can't really play a feature, can you? Let us know down there in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then why don't you pick up that subscribe button and swing around your head like a lasso and throw it over there, and be sure to check out NintendoLife.com for all sorts of lovely Nintendo-related content. Thank you again for watching. Bye-bye. Nil desperandum, let's crack on. Good lord, some of these are long buggers, aren't they?